And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity. The White March, Part 1. Blind. Jing! Okay. We need to... I don't know, should we rest? Might as well. The only reason I'm resting now... Yeah, I get spells back.
Sure.
Too. But over here... Is this a quest or a task? It's a task. Meztla and the Sisterhood of the Slaked Skull are over here. And what the hell? Aloth, what the hell are you doing all the way over there? We're gonna do our best to defeat them. If I need to camp again, I might be able to go to the Tarragair and get some more, camping supplies from him.
Be cautious. Be constant.
Mm-hmm. Crate is empty, though it smells strongly of fish. Right, they're up here somewhere. There's Meztla herself. Helgina activates ambushing. I'm not even sure what that is. Sorry about that, guys. Let's see. So since Kana can't unsheathe his weapon, we're gonna take him out of the mix here. And we're attacking ranged for now. Yep, Slake Skull Priestess, Cypher, Rogue, Paladin, and Wizard. Okay. Tough. Let's see if we can take her down first, maybe. I really don't like this theme very much. Killing bolt. Boom. Disintegrate. Or should I just try to take someone over? Every time I try to do that, she doesn't seem to have enough time to do it, but let me try. Mind plague, Ringleader on this monk. Okay, we've all got our tasks. She's getting hit left and right. And I can't even tell where... Who is who here? Palagina's right here. That's Meztla. Adair. Knock down the wizard, yeah. Kana. Knock down the priestess. Aloth's still casting his spell. Not that damaged, but could use a little healing. Where is she? Still using it, huh? Or trying to? Well, let's knock down Meztla then. Oh, wait. No, Adair's been turned evil. Damn it. I'm trying to turn someone good. Palagina's on her back. Dominate. Average. Can I dominate the priestess? Try. It worked. It worked. Okay. So now attack this cipher. Deidas is still trying to go with this crap. I should have used this to start out with. Sworn enemy. Can I also do this? Boom. No, I have to act. Okay, never mind. You never even used your spell. Maybe now you can use it. Use it on Meztla. Oh boy. Can we, like, get this off? This is quick, isn't it? Or average? Oh, she's paralyzed. What else do we have? Resurrection. Just trying to get off this heal anyway. Alright. Adair is still evil. Oh, damn, the priest has turned back already. Oh, wait, who am I controlling? Aeloth? But he finally got that off. One more time. I have to get him. Damn, cast your spell. Nope. Oh my god, I got three people on the priest. Adair is back, though. Oh my god, priest is almost down. There, do the knock. I'll only hit two of them. Just trying to get that spell off, huh? Ken is actually holding his own against the cipher. I'm kind of in trouble. I don't want to wait any longer. Three worms. Let me just wait till it gets four. Rush forward and do that. Keep healing. He's got his four there. Okay. Three worms. Priest is down. Revive him. Boom. They're running these things? Or it's dead already. Well, this monk is almost dead. Kill it first. And get rid of the paladin. Oh wait, no. Don't belay that auto. Yeah, revive him. Yeah. Forgot what I was doing for a second. Priest is back. Quick blessing, I hope. Kill the cipher, he's almost dead. I wonder if we can heal those worms. Last one? Everybody? Nice. That was a tough battle, but the priest almost fell unconscious just the second time. Find Morning Star, stilettos, assorted armor. Ooh. Forgotten Tear of the Beloved, Flail, huh. Weathered Grimoire. Potion of Minor Regeneration. Meztla's Head. This burlap sack contains the head of Meztla, leader of the Sisterhood of the Slaked Skull. Now defunct. So this is a flail. I wonder if this would be a good replacement for Theodas's weapon. 30% of graze is converted to hits. 10% chance to cast dazing on hit or critical hit. Grants prayer against treachery, one per rest. Plus 50 defense against charmed attacks. And minus 10 seconds for charmed duration. Plus 50 defense against dominate and minus 5 seconds dominate duration. Oh, that's cool. Devotees of Andra tell stories of her romance with the moons, especially her unrequited love for Sen Balafa. Yet it was Ioni Brather, the smaller of the two moons, that Andra pulled into the sea thousands of years ago. Small fragments of Ioni Brather are believed to exist in some of the more remote places of Eora. Lost tokens of the goddess's passion. Such moon fragments and the crater lakes that often form around them are known as Andra's Tears. This flail is made with a piece of Ioni Brather that was discovered by some of the Pargrunan dwarven explorers in the White March. Oh, wait. Alright, let's give it to her. I defeated the Sisterhood of the Slaked Skull and took Meztla's head as proof. Teodor waits in Stalwart to give me a reward for this bounty. Four copper. That guy was pretty poor. I hear something heavy.
Be cautious.
Moving around.
Be constant.
Okay, let's take a look at this item. So it is two flails. I thought she might have a mace. They're the same exact value. The Unforgiven flail hits for more, though. Plus 30 is the same here. Gives you plus 20% attack speed instead of the 10% thing here. Burn damage, I think I enchanted that on there. Suppress affliction is great, though. I'm gonna keep this. I'm afraid I'm gonna keep that. The Unforgiven. I dub it Unforgiven. Alright. Sneaky time.
No problem.
What's this? In the trampled, bloody slush around this toppled wagon, you spy tracks leading back south along the path. Oh, good. Camping supply. And a pry bar. That's what we heard. Bouncing, well, not bouncing, it was stomping around over there. Can you imagine if it was bouncing? That'd be pretty funny. Attack. Oh, I thought I had everyone selected. some reason a dare had the wrong weapon out. Some missiles there. Should take that thing and rest.
Hey.
That was an odd delay. Oh, she points at him like that? That's what that means. You are my sworn enemy, sir. Oh no, I don't want that one. This one. Oh, Kanya, what are you up to? Anna, are you sneaking? Stop that. Attack this thing.
Damn.
Kanna. Seriously now. Hit it.
Following your lead.
Finally following my lead. Ah, nice try. It's regenerating because not all you guys are hitting the frickin' thing.
Something over there.
Sheesh.
I'll see what I can find.
I still hear footsteps. We're like really damaged. Or not like, but we are really damaged. Let's hunker down by this caravan type thing. Toppled wagon. Yeah, we can't have a priest in such a state.
Laying low.
Alright, now let's go find the source of these. Stomping. Yeah, here we go. We got joined the party. Little tiny ice beetle and bigger ice beetle. Let's try that. Oh, what's that thing that knocks everyone down? Amplified wave? Oh, off of Paladino? Sure. Forgot how you do that.
I'm ready.
I am so annoyed how people just don't attack. Alright, hit this thing. See if you can flip it.
Hey.
Riff!
Following your lead.
So in other words, Palagina was just standing around doing nothing, like pretty much everyone else was. Thank you. These battles would be off a lot quicker if everyone just attacked. But even messing with the AI, I can't seem to get it right.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea.
Yeah, yeah.
Which is not very quiet.
Stairs up. Oh, what's that? Battery watchtower, interesting. Had no idea there was so much more of the place, that there were more inside zones to see. Dead end over here. Brentwin ban.
Hello. Hello.
We got over here. Nothing. Ooh, Talisman of the Unconquerable. +2 intellect while endurance is above 50%. +25% focus gain while endurance is above 50%. I'd say that's for a cipher. Now she has use of this, right? Intelligence. Tips lore. Will defense influences durations and area of effect for all abilities and talents. What's she wearing now? I'm gonna go for this. Once she's half, more than half damaged, or when she's half damaged or under, she'll be like stupid again. Nothing to be found. Still stuff to explore over here. Oh, still haven't gone in that cavern. You know, that reminds me. Back in the, what was it? I remember at FTW. Crap. Something that Fangs That Whisper, I believe? There's a ice slope or something that we didn't go down. Forgot about it. Alright, well, we're right here. Let's check the watchtower.
Nice and quiet.
We'll check it nice and quiet. Oh, he went right up. Oh, look at this. Oh, what's that? I don't know what to look at next. First. It's this device gives a series of clicks and the compass at its center points southwest. From the top of an outer tower east of the keep the device point southwest. Oh, here's a special thing. As you grab the bow, it vibrates with a strange and familiar energy. Searching your pack, you find the silver arrow that you found lodged in an injured winter wolf. As you hold the bow and arrow together, the arrow suddenly snaps into place. You hear a crackling hum, and a pale ribbon of light begins to form between the ends of the bow. When you pull the arrow back, you feel a very solid resistance. So I've gained this thing called Stormcaller. It's a bind soul thing. For use by Chanter, Cypher, or Ranger. Well, it's going to be Theodessa's, because we don't have a Ranger, and our Chanter already has a weapon that he can't even get rid of. I don't know how he lucked out and got the cursed one. Stop that. So it's 14 to 21 shock and pierce, minus 6 damage reduction. It's an exceptional weapon, so plus 8 accuracy and plus 30% damage. This bow is as smooth and light as driftwood, yet as hard as a sturdy mast. It feels warm in your hands, as if one of its previous owners had just passed it to you. As you hold it, you can almost feel the sea spray on your cheeks and hear storm-whipped waves in your ears. Oh man, kinda would have loved it, actually. Once, Stormcaller belonged to a young navigator on a merchant ship in the Deadfire Archipelago. She had an almost preternatural gift for predicting the weather. She could smell a storm brewing a day's journey away. On her final voyage, she detected a cyclone forming in their path. She instructed the captain to change course and seek shelter in a nearby strait, which he did. Unfortunately, a pirate ship was waiting there. The merchant vessel was boarded and its crew slain. Oh, damn. I want to compare it with... Hold on. It's the only way I know how to do that. I assume it's going to get better. Yeah, this is fast weapon on top of it. Okay. It's a little less damage. One point. But we've got shock. Added shock to it as well. Yep. Go. Deal 250 shock damage to enemies to unlock the next level. Kill 25 blights. Alright. Maybe we should just try to remember to have him attack blights. I haven't found any for a while. And Kana, unfortunately, is going to leave the team for a while to let the Devil of Karak in. Oh, he should just decipher the first verse. Okay. Interesting, that was just laying up here.
Nice and quiet.
That's it. Can't go any further. Can we go around this way? And then suppose we can jump and take a little in a little scripted thing. Choose your own adventure page. I like that, how it's seamlessly. No loading. Okay. So that's the watchtower. Let's see if I can just get over here. and get some camp stuff from him, and then we'll continue this way. Aye. They just all run around you. Awesome. Yeah. I'd save this stuff, but it'd be cool if we had a separate stash to keep stuff that we didn't want to sell. Because all the inventory slots fill up really quickly. So I end up selling stuff off just because it's easier that way. Okay. We got stuff. Oh, missed that. There you go. Oh, God. It scared me this time. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time and endure. In enduring, grow strong.
Hello? Hello?